Many thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much for calling me, and pleasure to be with you.
Well, let's start with the 19 players that you selected in the provisional squad, including the Netherlands best, Jean-Victor Mukama, who received his first call-up in the men's senior national basketball team. When do you expect the foreign best players to arrive in the country?
We called three guys beside those two. Kenny Gassana cannot be considered anymore like a foreigner. He is so many years, 11 years, he played for national team. We have a new guy who was thanks to Patriots and Mr. Bryan and all those other guys who are involved in that, president of Patriots and coach Dean Murray. They brought Adonis Filer, who is a strong, great prototype of the modern basketball player, and this would be a first occasion that we get, instead of big man, which was always requested, that we this time, I tried to convince and I succeeded because I have a very good committee and leadership, Mr. Desire and other people, Madame Pasquale, Mr. Richard and other guys, they agreed that this time we use opportunity to try with the point guard. Yes. About those other three guys, Elias Goga, Jean-Victor Mukama, and other guy whose name is Dylan Shomers. Those are three guys who play abroad, one in Texas Junior College.
So we should expect them coming very soon in the country?
We would know more in the following days.
But you are in communication with them?
Yes. Me and people from the committee, we do have regular communication. So, you know, it is the part of the business. It's selection. It goes 24 hours, 7 days. So we'll see.
Brilliant. There are new faces, but also a number of omissions.
Yes.
People that have been left out, including regular and experienced trio of Bugabigui and Hamza Reza Mihigo and the Aristide Mugabe, who is the captain of the national championship.
Yeah, great
the champions.
Guy, yes.
What informed your team selection?
Well, you know what? First of all, I came from abroad. And I come to not get local standards. This guy Hamza, of course, Aristide is still captain of Patriots. They won the title again. You can see his statistics, playing time and other things, and I would not go further in that discussion. So many times talking about that, so it's a little bit of becoming repetition.
Yeah.
But, for example, this guy Hamza, I never had a chance to say that guy, I know at least last 3 years didn't play. You see, that is the biggest problem if you want to develop the basketball in Rwanda on a level of those other six or eight countries top in Africa. But the good thing, government in Rwanda loves basketball. We have no chance to make happy our government and all fans if we continue to bring the people who are part-time in basketball or who don't have league, or as previous guy from Patriots, my friend Clement would say, statistics. That's very good that you have somebody local from Rwanda who says about that if you want to bring the player, he has to bring the statistics.
And Adonis?
Adonis is working job in United States.
Yeah. So he's not playing basketball.
He doesn't play basketball. That's an unfortunate, sad story, but that's the choice.
Rwanda did not perform very well. We all agree in the recent outing, which was the 2019 FIBA World Cup basketball qualifiers. Mm-hmm. So what is your goal in going into
About 2019, about Zone 5 is in Kampala Games?
No, I'm talking about the recent the qualifiers. You went to Nigeria, you were in Cote d'Ivoire, where you played all these games.
Yes.
World Cup qualifiers.
That was unfortunately reality. We, first of all, when I came, we succeeded the professional guy from the States called Darius Garrett.
Yeah.
He didn't come on one of those qualifications at all, and on the other, on the most important game against Central Africa, we were leading first half, and we were leading until the third quarter, up and down 2 points, but we were leading. That guy didn't play, he had injury. It's history now, but it's just a matter of the consistency, but they have to be standards. We have to have values for selections, and we have to push many young guys who are great athletes and who can compete in some level of game.
What is your goal going into? I know Rwanda has already qualified as the host country, but what is your goal going into these qualifiers, as well as your goal when Rwanda eventually hosts Afro Basketball? Very briefly.
First, in Afro Basketball, I think that being in the top eight, which we never were before, is the highest goal. Well, we should try in Afro Basket to go as far as we can. Hopefully, there will be no COVID, that will be fans, so we can get even higher. You know, the local court with fanatic fans helps a lot, but also, you know, in the disqualifications, we have to try to win as much as we can. If we can win all, why don't we do that?
As we conclude this, what should the fan of basketball in Rwanda know as we go into the Afro Basketball qualifiers?
Basketball people in Rwanda,
yes,
have to know that we have to start building winning attitude.
Vladimir Bosnak, many thanks for your time indeed.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate it, and wish you good luck.
We need your support, and I hope soon in your studio would be some players. Thank you very
Brilliant.
Much.
Thanks a lot.